Good morning, students. Let's see the 13th group. Continuity of 13th group. Okay. In that, formation of oxides. That means 13th group elements, when interact with oxygen, they form corresponding oxides. And they, what is the nature of that oxides? 13th group elements interact with oxygen, they form oxides. Okay. Now, what is the nature of that oxide? Is it acidic, basic, or amphoteric? Okay, so very important topic. Okay, let's see it. So, formation of oxides. Okay, so we have 13th group elements. So, what are 13th group elements? Can anybody? 13th group elements. 13th group or third A group elements, these are belongs to third A group elements. Group means from top to bottom in the periodic table, am I right? Group means from top to bottom in the periodic table, nothing but of column in the periodic table. Okay. So now what is the first element? Boron, aluminium, gallium, indium, and thallium. These are the boron, aluminium, gallium, indium, thallium. These are 13th group elements. Okay. Now these 13th group elements, these mostly having +3 oxidation state. It is highly positive. And here gallium can also exhibit +3. Indium also exhibit +3, okay. But this is +3 is not a stable oxidation state for gallium, indium and thallium. Remember this. But okay, so these are mostly exhibit +1. This is stable oxidation state. Is it clear? Okay. Here this is the stable oxidation state. +3 is the stable oxidation state. Remember these points. Now 13th group oxides. 13th group oxides are, the first oxides is, 13th group oxides are sesiqui oxide. 13th group oxides are called as sesiqui oxides. Okay, so what is mean by that? Sesiqui oxide means 13th group oxides are in the form of M2O3 or X2O3, where MRX is equals 13th group elements. 13th group element. Okay. A ratio of oxygen and 13th group elements, it may be M, R, X, boron, aluminum, gallium, or thallium, like that. Okay? Is Oxygen and 13th group elements, 3:2 ratio, am I right? How many oxygens are here? We have 3. How many X here? We have 2. Okay? Such oxides are called as acidic oxide. Okay? So, the oxide in which oxygen and 13th group element ratio is 3:2. 3:2. That means 2 atoms of 13th group elements and 3 atoms are oxygen, am I right? 3 atoms oxygens and 2 atoms 13th group elements. Then what is the ratio of oxygen and 13th group element? 3:2. Okay? Such kind of oxygens are called as acidic oxides. Is it clear? So now 13th group elements, such oxides are called acidic oxides. That means ratio of 13th group element on oxygen in which ratio? Clearly, it is in 3:2. That means 3 oxygen atoms are present and 2 atoms of 13th group elements. That element may be boron, aluminium, gallium, indium, thallium. Okay, is it clear, all of you, everyone? So very, very important topic this one. Write the notes neatly. Okay, up to now, what are the oxides? 13th group oxides are, 13th group oxides are, 13th group oxides are, the first one is Al2O3, in this format Al2O3, and before this B2O3, am I right? Next, boron, aluminium, gallium, Ga2O3, I2O3, Tl2O3. These are all 13th group elements, am I right? 13th group oxides. Now these elements with oxygen is called as oxides. So remember, here we are very, very important. This B2O3 is more acidic in nature. Very, very important. More acidic in nature. Okay? And the remaining two, Al2O3, are amphoteric nature. These two are basic nature. Okay? Amphoteric means act as either acid or base. That means simply act as acid and also base. Act as acid and also base. Both nature having, then we call it is amphoteric in nature. Okay? Act as acid. So now these two are basic in nature. First one is more acidic in nature. Okay? Now write the question. First one, more acidic and also less basic. More acidic means, remember this point, less basic. Is it clear? More acidic and less basic. Okay, Mark? So, question number, which of the following oxide of 13th group shows more acidic nature, more acidic nature, more acidic, more acidic nature. Option A, Al2O3. Option B, B2O3. Option C, Ga2O3. Option D, In2O3. Which one is correct one? B2O3 is more acidic. Am I right? This is the correct answer. And less basic. Remember this. Okay. Which of the pair of oxides shows amphoteric in nature? Amphoteric in nature. Option A, Al2O3, Ga2O3. Option B, Al2O3 and Tl2O3. C is In2O3 and Tl2O3. Which one is more amphoteric in nature? So this pair is more amphoteric in nature. Am I right? Which of the following pair of oxides shows more basic nature? Option A, Al2O3 and Ga2O3. Option B, Al2O3 and Tl2O3. Option C, In2O3 and Tl2O3. Which one is correct one? And option D, B2O3 and Tl2O3. Okay. So which one is the correct one? More basic means, so these are the most basic oxide, 13th group. Okay, clear? Is it clear, ma, all of you? So here we need to discuss about again thallium trioxide, that is Tl2O3. So is basic, you know, basic nature, that means base. Now what about this one? Thallium oxide. What about this one? I said that here it is more basic than Tl2O3. I said that Tl2O is more basic than Tl2O3. What is the reason? Why? Tl2O is more basic than Tl2O3. That is my question. Okay. And now solution for this, very very important. JEE and NEET. Okay. So now solution for thallium trioxide, where the oxidation state of thallium is
how many thallium here we have 2, so x3 into oxygen minus 2 is equals 0. 2x is equals plus 6, x is equals how much? Plus 6 by 2, that is x equals to plus 3. That means here thallium shows plus 3 oxidation state, am I right? What is the oxidation state of thallium in this compound? Plus 3. Now come to thallium oxide, Tl2O. What is the oxidation state? 2x plus 1 oxygen carries minus 2 charge, am I right? Now 2x is equals to plus 2, x equals to how much? Plus 2 by 2, that is equals x equals to plus 1. That means here it exhibits plus 1 oxidation state. So in thallium compounds, thallium mostly shows plus 1 oxidation state, am I right? That is the stable oxidation state already we discussed. So here thallium plus 1 is more stable than thallium plus 3. Am I right? So thallium plus 1 shows plus 1 oxidation state like alkali metals, that is first A group elements. First A group elements, what are they? That is lithium plus, sodium plus, potassium plus, rubidium plus, cesium plus, francium. These are all first A group elements. Are high stable oxidation state is their stable oxidation state is plus 1. Okay, so their bases are high basic in nature. Example, sodium hydroxide is a strong base. So these produce strong bases. Okay, so here their oxides are also strong bases. Suppose what is the oxides of this one? Here it is Na2O sodium oxide, K2O potassium oxide, Li2O lithium oxide, rubidium oxides. Okay, like that. So these are all strong basic in nature. Basic in nature, am I right? Basic in nature, strong basic in nature, oxides also. First A group elements also more strong basic in nature. So now why we compare these first A group elements with third A group element thallium plus 1? Simple, thallium shows plus 1, that is the most stable oxidation state for it. Okay, so in the same manner, in the second A group, first A group elements also, first A group elements shows plus 1, that is the stable oxidation state. That means both are similar or not? They are resemble or not? That means thallium plus 1 is resemble or similar to first A group metals. Okay, is it clear? So these oxides are strong base in nature. So corresponding oxide thallium oxide is more basic than thallium trioxide. Okay, clear all of you? So thallium oxide is more basic than thallium trioxide. So very, very important. Write the question. Which of the following is correct order of basic strength of thallium oxide and thallium oxide? Option A, thallium plus is more basic than. Option B, Tl2O3 is greater than T
Tl2O2 option C. Tl2O3 is equivalent to Tl2O3 option D. Tl2O3 is more basic. Which one is correct, ma? This one is correct.
This one is correct.
Due to Tl plus 1 is stable, then Tl plus 3 and Tl plus 2 similar to first in group ions, which are clear. That is the reason.
So now here we have acetic oxide B2O3 and Al2O3 gallium Ga2O3 or amphoteric, that means act as both acidic and basic. They can able to act as acid and also basic. That phenomenon is called as amphoteric in nature. Okay, and remaining both are basic in nature. Okay, now I would like to write some important equation to confirm these oxides are acidic, basic and amphoteric. Let's see it. In that, first we go for B2O3. So boric anhydride or boron trioxide. Boric anhydride, name of this, or boron trioxide. Okay. So what about this one? It is a more acidic and less basic, am I right? Less basic. So it is acidic means it can able to interact with the base or not? Base. Let us take COO, cobalt oxide. Interact with B2O3, boric anhydride, it gives COBO2 taken twice. Okay, name of this one is cobalt metaborate. Cobalt metaborate. Now it is a blue color bead. Bead means nothing but of crystal, you know, glasses are different colors, you know. Some of the glasses are blue in color, some of the glasses are black in color, am I right? Some are completely colorless, am I right? So now if you want to make the glass as a blue color, now that glass is having some quantity of these cobalt metaborate. Due to this cobalt, the glass having blue in color, am I right? It gets blue in color. So remember this. So now which color of bead? COBO2 take it, I don't write capital O. This is the symbol for cobalt. Okay, cobalt. Okay, it is a metal, am I right? So we call it is metal metaborate. Why? Because cobalt is a metal. Okay, which is makes a blue color bead. It gives due to the cobalt. Okay, so blue color it is. Remember this. This one is very very important. Okay, so cobalt oxide. Now interact with B2O3. What is the nature of B2O3? You know that it is acidic. This is acidic means this one is basic, am I right? So acid interact with base, am I right? So now what is the nature of this one? Base. What is the nature of acidic? So now this reaction confirm that B2O3 is an acidic nature. Why? Because it is base. Acid can only interact with base, am I right? So this reaction shows that or confirm that B2O3 is clearly acidic in nature. Why? Because it is base. Acid interact with base, am I right? Let's see one more example. Copper oxide interact with B2O3. It is also metal oxide which is in base. Metal oxide. Clear? Boric anhydride. What is the nature? Acidic nature. Clear? Remember this. What it gives? CuBO2 taken twice. Instead of Cu, write Cu.
It is also copper. Copper metaborate. Copper metaborate. So it is also blue color bead. Blue color bead. Am I right? Remember these two. So finally, what we conclude from this? Above two reactions shows B2O3 is a acidic oxide. Clear? Acidic oxide. Is it clear, all of you? Okay. What is the color of this bead? Bead. We call it is bead. Blue color bead. This one is also same. Okay. And next, gopher. Now B2O3 interact with P4O10, which is called strong acid. This is also acid, but this one is strong acid. When comparing with strong acid, here B2O3 is somewhat less acidic and it acts as a less basic also. Remember this. When comparing, this also acid, this is also acid, but it is strong acid. Now along with or besides P4O10, B2O3 is a very weak, less basic. That means it is in some tactics less basic also. Less basic. Why? Because it is strong acid tactics. So in this case, it is less basic in nature. Act as a base here in this particular case. Okay. Now what it gives? BPO4, 4 moles of boron. Okay. BPO4 BPO4 let's see, keep 2 here, 2 is 4, keep here 4 borons, 4 is 16, 2 3 is 6, 10 16, phosphorus 4. Okay, is it clear? How many phosphorus here we have? 4. Here 4 phosphorus, how many borons? 4. Here 2 is 4, 2 3 is 6, and 10 16 oxygen, 4 is 16. Okay. So now this reaction, so what it is? Clearly basic in nature. Remember this. Why it is strong acid? And B2O3 also less basic. It can interact with arsenic AS4, gives rise to 4 BASO4. Okay, and 2 2 4, clear? 4 AS, 10 16 oxygen. Clear? Now it is strong acid, am I right? So B2O3, when interact with strong acids, it acts as a base, less base. Initial I told that it is more acidic and less basic also. So it interact with strong acids. Is it clear? So remember that too also. And next come to Al2O3 and gallium trioxide. What about this? These two are amphoteric. I told that. Okay. Next come to Al2O3 and Ga2O3 oxides of 13th group. These are amphoteric in nature. Am I right? These are amphoteric in nature. That means these are acts as acidic and also basic compounds. Both nature, Al2O3 act as acidic and also base. Ga2O3 acidic and also base. Such compounds are called as amphoteric in nature. Okay, clear? Suppose Al2O3 interact with HCl, it gives aluminum trichloride and 3H2O. Balance this equation. Here 2 it is 2, 2 3 is 6 chlorine, 6 hydrogen, 3 2 is 3 oxygen, 3 oxygen. So that means here it is, HCl is acid, am I right? Hydrochloric acid. That means what is the nature here? Base. That means here Al2O3 acts as base. Why? Because it interacts with acid. So it is a salt. Salt. Okay. Al2O3 interacts with NaOH, am I right? Sodium hydroxide, which is strong base. Strong base. That means what is the nature of this one? Acid, am I right? Okay, clear? So now this is sodium meta aluminate and H2O. Okay? So here Al2O3 can also act as base also. In this case, it is acid. When it is interacting with acid, it acts as base. Am I right? So balance this equation. See here, how many? Here we have two aluminum, keep two here. Here two Na, here keep two here. Two oxygens, 2 plus 3, 5. Here 2 2 4 plus 1, 5. Two hydrogens, two hydrogens. Clearly balanced. Okay. So now what we conclude from this one? Here Al2O3 acts as acid and also base. Okay. And the same manner, gallium trioxide interact with the base. It can also interact with acid like this. Okay. Na, GaO2 and H2O. Same equation. 2NaOH. Okay. And this is base. That means this is acid here. Am I right? Okay, so it acts as acid. This same reaction, GaO2 can also interact with HCl like this. GaCl3, gallium trichloride. So that means these both are act as acid and also base. Am I right? Clear? Now this is 2. Okay, H2O and 2NaOH, Al2O3. So this reaction represents that Al2O3 also act as acid and also bases. Okay, is it clear, ma'am? That means amphoteric in nature. So why these are amphoteric? Next, go for last page, that is Tn2O3 and In2O3. These two oxides are more basic in nature. Am I right? More basic in nature. More basic nature. Okay. Tl2O3 interact with H2SO4. H2SO4 sulfuric acid. This is acid, means here it acts as base or not? Base. Is it base or not? Base. More base. Okay. It gives thallium sulfate. Thallium sulfate and H2O. Thallium sulfate and H2O. Here we have two thalliums. Keep two here. Okay. Two thallium. Okay. And 6 plus 4, 10 oxygen. Here it is. 3, 4, 12, 13. sulfurs. Here we have three sulfurs. Thallium sulfate balance this equation. Two thalliums here. Thallium sulfate, clear, and it gives H2O. That means how many hydrogens here we have? Two hydrogens, two hydrogens. Sulfurs here we have three sulfurs, and keep three here. Three, three four are 12. 12 plus six. 12 plus six 18. 18 oxygen, and here 6 H2O. Let's see. 3 4 jar 12. 12 plus 6 oxygen. How much? 18. 3 4 jar 12. 2 3 jar 6. 18. 2 thalliums, 2 thalliums. Sulfurs 3 and 3. 6 hydrogens. Here we have, and here we 3 2 jar 6. Here it is 12. Thallium sulfate, thallium plus 3 is sulfate, clear, and H2O, clear that. And here two thalliums we have, three sulfurs, so we have to write two here. Thalliums are balanced, okay. And what about this one? 6 oxygens here, hydrogens come to, here we have 2 hydrogens, 2 hydrogens, sulfurs, 3 sulfurs, so have to write 3, okay. Now 2 3 ja 6, 2 3 ja 6 oxygen, 3 4 ja 12, 18, 18 means, here it is, 3 4 ja 12, it is 3, here it is 12 plus 3, 15 only, so right here 6 oxygens, 3 4 jar 12, 18, 6 into 2, 12 hydrogens, and here it is, suppose 6 sulfurs means keep 2 here, 4, keep 4 here, now 4 thalliums, 4 thalliums, okay, 6 sulfurs, 6 sulfurs, and oxygens, 4 3 is 12, 24, 36, here, 1 minute, it's not balanced, I think. Just keep here, I will tell you. So then go for next one, thallium sulfate. This represents acid base interact with the acid, am I right? So what is the nature? Thallium oxide act as a base, am I right? And remember that thallium oxide, where it is plus 1, interact with water, it gives thallium hydroxide, thallium hydroxide, okay. Two thalliums here we have, okay. So two hydrogens, two hydrogens, two oxygens, two oxygens, clear. So more basic here it is, basic in nature, remember this, special for, okay. So now why B2O3 is acidic and Al2O3 and Ga2O3 is amphoteric and Tl2O3 and In2O3 is basic. So very important, we should know the reason. So now let us take B2O3 boric anhydride. Okay, this boric anhydride acidic in nature because it shows B plus 3. What is the oxygen state here? B plus 3, that is more positive, am I right? More positive means it can easily gain the electrons. Why? Because it is positive. Okay, so when dissolved in water, what is the structure of water? This is the structure of water. Bond means 2 electrons, am I right? This bond 2 electrons, am I right? Clear everyone? So now B plus 3 with water. Okay, now B plus 3 pulls off 2 electrons from O bond H of H2O, and it produces H plus ions in solution. So H plus means solution become more acidic. Is it clear? More acidic. That means, listen carefully, what is the meaning of that? This is boron plus 3, am I right? B2O3. When dissolved in water, now what is the interaction? It gives B plus 3, am I right? B plus 3, and it is interact with OH. Here we have 2 electrons. Now this is positive, this is electronegative. Okay, now this B plus 3 try to break this bond. We call it is rupture also. Rupture of OH bond electrons by B plus 3. That means it pulls these electrons from OH. That means it becomes, water becomes H plus and OH minus in the solution. Okay, so H pluses are removed from water. That means solution becomes acidic. So is it clear, ma'am? This B plus 3 interact these 2 electrons and it produce H plus in the solution. It produce H plus in the solution. So solution becomes acidic in nature. So B2O3 is more acidic. How B2O3 becomes more acidic? When dissolved in water, this B plus 3 interact the OH electrons and
it remove the H plus from OH from water. So now solution consists H plus, am I right? That means it becomes acidic in nature. In this way, B2O3 become acidic. Okay.
So now B plus 3 is small size, you know, small size also in the 13th group, small size ion in 13th group. In 13th group. Is it clear, all of you? Okay. Next, amphoteric means why? Amphoteric nature of Al2O3 and Ga2O3. Why? So now Al plus 3 and Ga plus 3 from this. When water. Okay. So now these also pulls these electrons, produce H plus, and it is also pulls these two electrons and it produce H plus. Okay. So it has less tendency Al plus 3 and Ga plus 3 has less tendency to rupture of OH electrons from OH bond of a H2O. That means H plus not easily produce, but is less when compared with B plus 3. When compared with B plus 3. Okay. It has less tendency to produce H plus. So these are act as amphoteric. B plus 3 easily produce H plus. These are have somewhat less tendency to compare with B plus 3. Now what about this one? And note here, size of Al plus 3 and gallium plus 3 higher than B plus 3. Remember this. And come to last one. And In2O3, we said that basic. Why? Size of thallium plus 3 and indium plus 3 is very higher than B plus 3, Al plus 3 and gallium plus 3. Okay. So interaction of thallium plus 3 and indium plus 3 negligible with water. So they are basic in nature. Okay. So these are not willing to interact with water. That's why they are basic. Originally basic. They are unable to produce H plus. So not willing to produce H plus in the aqueous medium. That is unable to rupture of OH bond electrons from H2O. Okay, so more basic. So more basic. That means unable to produce H plus. Here rupturing means remove the H plus from water. That means rupture. Okay, is it clear, ma? Write it down, all of you. Okay students, see the equation. When thallium interact with sulfuric acid, thallium oxide, it gives thallium sulfate plus H2 So H2 gas is liberated here. So okay, so that means here thallium source plus 1 oxidation state. This is the equation. Okay, write down this. Okay, students, we will meet again on tomorrow. Have a nice day.